Now we're cutting over to Tiaroa for a miniature TT course we had in the Tiaroa domain and football fields in March 1971, just a couple of weeks after the Tui Karamea meeting. Notice Doug was working in the tent there. Doug has been doing a pretty good job in the tent. Bruce Weeks, he wasn't our president then. Some of the boys did some slides in practice here. It was a bit wet and greasy until they marked themselves out a decent track with those great big tyres they have in the back. A fairly fast course we had. Actually, it was a wee bit too fast for comfort. The riders were going down alongside that fence there, only a foot or so away at about 70 miles an hour, and the children would poke their head out through the fence to have a better look. This is Peter Ploen, still number 7, and this time riding a CZ. Particular race was won by Alan Collison. Doug McLaren was Ross McLaren was second, and Hugh Anderson was third. The model aeroplane boys have come out from Tui Karamea to give a demonstration of Tiaroa here, and we'll see them later on. Looks like Snoopy and the Red Baron are here once more. Graeme Lawrence, fresh from his victories over at Singapore, presents the prizes for the 250 New Zealand Championship. Wally Sheriffs wins it. Wally Sheriffs first. They have it. Doug Johnson was second. A good ride by Doug. And third place man was Laurie Love. Laurie was just starting to come up from Whanganui Way and race up this way. Well, the Red Baron and Snoopy are going to have another go by the looks of this, and they tell me that one of the meetings these two were having a dog fight, they cut the tail off one of the planes. collided and chewed the tail off Snoopy. So Snoopy is no more. Mm-hmm. if he pushes that wrong toggle, he'll have an upside-down plane crash land at about 120 miles an hour. That was a marvellous demonstration of model aeroplane flying and a beautiful landing. Dave Johnson does a very classy corner here on his dot. Sheriffs on his Yamaha, they were cornering into this corner at about 70, 73 or 4 miles an hour. It was very, very fast. Sheriffs wins another 250 race. He's unbeatable on 250s today. Any hope a bike doesn't plough down that fence? The big stuff again, Hugh Anderson on the 400 Husqvarna, Alan Collison, Alan Franklin, Ross McLaren, Doug McLaren, Peter Ploen, they're all in there. This can only be Peter Ploen, surely, in yellow. Assy corner by Doug McLaren here on his CZ. Yes, this could only be Peter Ploen. Looks like Ross McLaren could be in front here. I think that's Ross McLaren in front in yellow. Let's have a look and see. Hugh Anderson comes in first. Ross McLaren, Alan Collison. Peter Ploen must have fallen off somewhere in the line. Now he's there. Black flag looks very ominous for somebody's going to get the works from Errol McCabe, the ACU steward. Graeme Lawrence doing a very classy corner there. Mm-hmm. Dave Catherwood on his CZ. Alan Collison, really great rider is Alan, very, very consistent. Peter Ploen all over the bike, just like he does with his Yamahas and Kawasaki's and anything else that he rides. Doug McLaren. And Ross has got his nose in front of Peter, and he could just about win that race, I think. It sure was dry and dusty in there. Called up for the presentation of another championship, and Mr. Skidmore, the mayor of Te Aroha, a great sport and a great worker, he was parking cars during the day. Congratulates everybody, thanks the spectators for coming. And this will be just about the end of the film. And with these shots of Morley Sheriff first, Hugh Anderson second, Brian Lawrence third, getting their ribbons from Mr. Skidmore, will say cheerio to Te Aroha, March 1971. (laughs)